In this lecture, we will discuss about assignment solution of week 6 of subject antenna. And the name of the week or name of the topic is broadband microstrip antenna, that is BMSA. So in this video, we will discuss about some MCQ and examples related with microstrip antenna. So let's start. If thickness of substrate is increased by 2 times and the dielectric constant is reduced by 4 times, its bandwidth will increase or decrease. So this is the equation of bandwidth, width and dielectric constant. So bandwidth is proportional to width divided by square root of epsilon r. Okay, so h is the width, or we can say the height, epsilon r is the dielectric constant, bw is the bandwidth. So if we increase the width by 2 times, so in place of h you put 2h, okay, and dielectric constant is reduced by 4 times, so epsilon r is replaced by epsilon r divided by 4. So you will get new bandwidth BW2. So BW2 divided by BW1, that is equal to 4. That means the new bandwidth is reduced by 4 times the previous bandwidth. So the answer is A. So the old bandwidth, that is equal to 4 times the new bandwidth. Okay, so the answer is A, because whatever the bandwidth we are getting is generally increased by 4 times as compared to previous bandwidth. So the answer is A. Efficiency of microstrip antenna can be decreased by, so if you want to increase the microstrip antenna efficiency, you have to reduce dielectric constant. Okay, and to reduce the efficiency, we have to increase dielectric constant. Okay, because dielectric constant, the increased dielectric constant, the gain is increased, efficiency is also increased, but reducing dielectric constant reduce the efficiency. So the answer is B. Gap coupled MSE with one parasitic patch along the radiating edge has, so gap coupled MSE, microstrip antenna with parasitic patch generally have increased bandwidth as well as radiation pattern asymmetry. Okay, so B and C both are correct. So the answer is D. A three gap coupled RMSA configuration is designed. The feed point of the gap coupled with respect to only RMSA shift away from the center of MSP. So this is the part of the theory. It is a straightforward answer. So if you configuration is designed three gap coupled RMSA, then definitely the load or the point shift away from the center of MSA. So the answer is B. Which of the following configuration provide maximum bandwidth? So generally, three gap coupled RMSA with unequal parasitic elements. Okay, this is the statement derived from the theoretical parts of gap coupled rectangle microstrip antenna. As the number of gap coupled antenna increases, area increases, then the efficiency and bandwidth definitely improves or provides the maximum. So the answer is D. As the gap between parasitic patch and fail element increase, so generally the loop size, it depends upon the parasitic patch and feed element gap. Okay, so if the gap between the parasitic patch and feed element increase, then definitely loop size also decreases. So the answer is C. It is inversely proportional to the loop size. So the answer is C. Electromagnetically coupled two metallic rectangle patches are stacked on each other in air with support of metallic post at the center. The parasitic patch should have, so generally parasitic patch is passive patch, we can say that it is not active patch. So generally its length is less than the active patch, or active patch is known as fed patch. So the length is always less than fed patch. So answer is A. In the gap coupled RMSA, if parasitic patch length decreases, then what is the condition in the loop? So generally both P and C, loop in impedance plot moves in clockwise direction as well as resonance frequency increase. So B and C both are right. So answer is D. Both P and C. So answer is D. Aperture coupled MSA provides. Generally, aperture coupled MSA is widely used because of the following advantage. It have large bandwidth, undesired back radiation, and design flexibility. So the answer is D. All of the above. Now example is given. Circular MSA is given. Operating frequency is 1.8 GHz. And substrate parameters are also given. To increase the bandwidth, substrate thickness h is doubled. The modified patch radius for this thickness should be for operation at 1.8 GHz. This is the operating, or we can say that the radius of the patch of the circular MSA is given by A1 is equal to 8.791 divided by f0 square root of epsilon e minus height upon square root of epsilon r. Now height is increased by 2 times. So a2 is equal to, this statement is common, and in place of h put 2h. So now if you arrange a2 in terms of a1, then a2 is equal to a1 minus height upon square root of epsilon r. So now a1 is given to you. Okay, so what is the value of a1? It is 32.6. H is also given to you. Height is given 1.6 millimeter. Epsilon r is also given to you, 2.2. You will calculate. You will find a2 is equal to 31.5 millimeter. So the answer is C. What will be the approximate gain? So generally for circular MSA, gain is generally between 8 to 10. So now 9 is the correct option. So answer is B. What should be the approximate feed point location for the above configuration? So generally feed point location, if you observe the answer C, what is the radius of the patch? So generally radius is the patch radius, whatever the patch is given to you, that is very close to the feed point. So 31.5 is the patch. So what is the value closer to 31.5? It's a D. Okay, so feed point must be in nearest to the or closer to the fed patch. So the answer is D. Okay. Two identical circular patches are gap coupled with very small gap on left and right side of the fed circular patch. Radius is given, height is given. What should be the radius of the parasitic patch? So now if you carefully observe that in previous case, what we have the radius of the main point. So radius is 31.5. So it is the fed patch. Okay. So parasitic patch have radius slightly less than the fed patch. So what is the value 31.5 less than? What is the value less than 31.5 is 31.2. So the answer is A. Okay, these two are all much more less than that, but we have to find the one of the closest match to that. So answer is A. For conventional microstrip antenna design, if height of the substrate increases, then definitely bandwidth is increases as well as efficiency decrease. Okay, so height increase, bandwidth is increase. Bandwidth increase, then definitely gain decrease. And if gain decrease, then efficiency is also decrease. Okay, so option 1, 3 and 4 are correct, but 1, 3 are 4 and 4 are not given together in option. Only 1 and 3 are given. Okay, so the answer is C. For same substrate specification, two gap coupled semicircular MSA provide dash in comparison with the conventional circular MSA. So generally, two gap coupled semicircular MSA microstrip antenna generally provides broader bandwidth compared to conventional as well as non-uniform gain. Okay, broader bandwidth as well as non-uniform gain. So the 1 and 4 are correct. So the answer is B. Electromagnetically coupled two metallic circular patches are stacked on each other in air with support of metallic post at the center. The parasitic patch should have, so generally parasitic patch having length and radius both are less than the feed patch. So the answer is B. Which of one of the following configuration of microstrip antenna has least bandwidth? So generally air suspended microstrip antenna generally have lower bandwidth as compared to gap coupled and directly coupled or electromagnetically coupled. So the answer is A. An air suspended rectangle MSA is given to you. Height, patch length and width is also given to you. Frequency, resonating frequency 2.45 GHz is also given. Now to increase the bandwidth, which of the following option are possible? So if the patch is increased to 6 mm for the same patch width and frequency of operation, then what is the modified patch length? Okay, so now new patch having height is given to you 6 mm. It is already given to you, new patch height. Okay, and old patch height is given to 2 mm. So now that what is the gap between the two height? It is 4 mm, 6 minus 2. Now, you know the value of L effective, that is L is equal to L plus 2 delta L. Okay, so now L effective is nothing but the value of the length of previous patch. So L1 is given to you, that is equal to 57. So L effective is equal to L1 and that is equal to 57 minus 2 delta L. Delta L is equal to height divided by delta height divided by square root of epsilon E. Delta height is what? 6 minus 2, that is equal to 4. If you put all this value, then we will find that what is epsilon E. So epsilon E is generally less than epsilon R, and in this case it is air suspended, so epsilon A is equal to 1. So if you calculate, then L is equal to 50 millimeter. So the modified page have length 50 millimeter. Answer is D. Rectangle metallic patch stack vertically at gap of 5 mm from the bottom patch if it is electromagnetically coupled. For the same patch with 61 mm, approximate length of the patch will be what? Okay, so now in previously what we have find? 50 mm, okay. So the new patch must have less than value less than 51 mm. So what is the value less than 51? It is 46 mm. So the now answer is A, it is straightforward, okay. What will be the approximate peak gain for rectangle patch or rectangle cavity? Generally gain is in between 8 to 10 dBi. So always rectangle microstrip antenna having gain between 8 to 10. So the answer is B. Okay. It is also given that air suspended rectangle MSA. Okay. So generally rectangle MSA have gain that is in between 8 to 10. So the rectangle MSA has gain between 8 to 10. So answer is B. Okay, so gain of the RMSA or rectangle RMSA, rectangle MSA gain is generally less than between 8 to 10. So the answer is B. Okay, so this is the approximate peak gain. Okay, it is the highest gain. So generally, rectangle microstrip antenna has gain between 8 to 10 dBi. Okay, so now the answer of the rectangle microstrip antenna gain is between 8 to 10 dBi. Answer is B. Two identical rectangle patches have gap coupled at 2 mm on both the sides. What entire data is given? What will be the approximate length of the parasitic patch? Generally, length and radius of the parasitic patches must be less than the feed patch. So in previous case, what we have value of the feed patch? If you recall that, yes, this is 50 mm. Okay, so the value must be less than the 50 mm. So here the length is given 57 millimeter, okay, whatever the feed patch length, okay, original length is 50, active patch is 57. So the parasitic patch must have value less than 57. So what is less than 57 is 54. So the answer is C. The stack the planar microstrip configuration are given to you. Which are the following, which provides which of the following? It generally provides a broader bandwidth as well as uniform gain and stable radiation pattern. Okay, so these two options are already we have covered in previous MCQ. Just option 3 is optimized. So the answer is B, 1, 2, and 3. For a given substrate height H, which of the following configuration provides a substrate dielectric constant will give highest VSWR bandwidth for RMSA? So generally epsilon R is equal to 1 provides higher bandwidth VSWR. Answer is A. Which of the following techniques cannot be used to improve bandwidth of the microstrip antenna? So generally, if you cut the corners of the RMSA, then definitely bandwidth will decrease. So the answer is C. Radiating edge gap coupled RMSA is given to you. Okay, this is the feed patch and these both are parasitic patch. All the data are given to you. Frequency range is also given, epsilon R and H are also given. We have to find out the value of the L, the central patch having length what? Okay, so this is rectangle microstrip antenna. So width is given by C divided by 2F1 square root of epsilon R plus 1 divided by 2. Now we have two frequency range. Okay, so now what is the bandwidth? 970 MHz minus 880 MHz. So our bandwidth is 90. And from bandwidth, we can find out the two frequency. One is the higher lower cutoff frequency, another is the higher cutoff frequency. So lower cutoff frequency is equal to lower frequency plus bandwidth, required bandwidth divided by 3. So answer is 910 as well as higher cutoff frequency is equal to higher frequency minus bandwidth required bandwidth divided by 3. So it is 940 megahertz. So now put F1 in this equation, you will find the value of width. Okay. And now what is the length? We have to find out the length. So LE is equal to L plus 2 delta L. Okay. So what is LE? LE is equal to C divided by 2 F1 epsilon E. So F1 is here, epsilon E is not given, but epsilon R is given, 2.55. So epsilon E is just less than that. So it is 2.45. Put a value of this, you will get the value of LE. Put LE over here. And what is delta L? Delta L is equal to height divided by square root of epsilon E. Put value of delta L over here, you will get the value L. So L is equal to 10.1 centimeter. What is the value of L1? Coupled patch, parasitic patch. So generally L1 value always less than L. So what we have value L over here 10.1. So answer is must be 10.1, less than 10.1. What is the value closer to 10.1 is 9.8. So answer is B. Now Smith chart is given to you. what is the feed point location x that we have to find to improve the impedance matching. So generally feed point location must be close to the this couple parasitic patch length. So now length is given as a 9.8, so which value is closer to 9.8? Okay, so yet we have to find. And generally this Smith chart turns into in clockwise direction, that means in the right side direction. So generally feed point location should be shifted to the right. Answer is D. Which of the following configuration can increase the VSWR bandwidth without increasing the volume of antenna? So generally both gap coupled semicircular CMSA and RMSA with U slot. Answer is D, which increase the VSWR bandwidth. Now electromagnetically coupled RMSA configuration is given to you. Here the L1 is the bottom patch and L2 is the forward patch or up patch, top patch. Frequency is also given to you. Frequency range 1.7 GHz to 2 GHz. Delta 1 is given and delta 2 is also given. What is the value of L1? Okay, so first find out the bandwidth. So 2 GHz minus 1.7 GHz, that will give you 0.3 GHz. Now what is the F1 lower cutoff frequency? That is equal to 1.7 plus 0.3 divided by 3, that will give you 1.8 GHz. What is the higher cutoff frequency? F2 is equal to 2 GHz minus 0.3 divided by 3, that will give you 1.9 GHz. So now we have to find out the value L. So L is equal to LE1 minus 2 delta L. LE is equal to L plus 2 delta L. What is value of LE? L is equal to height divided by or C divided by 2 F1 square root of epsilon E. Okay, so put the value of F1, C and epsilon E. You will find 8.33 centimeter LE. What is delta L? Delta L is equal to height divided by square root of epsilon E. So now height is also given to you. So it is equal to 0.9. Okay, 0.9 multiplied by height. So height is given as a 1 centimeter. Okay, so and multiply with 0.9 because fringing field that we have to also consider. So what is the value of L1? Put the value of LE1 and delta L, that will give you 6.5 centimeter. Okay, so answer is B. What is the value of upper patch? So generally upper patch must be value less than lower patch. So lower patch value is 6.5. So which value is closer to less than 6.5? That is equal to 5.5. So the answer is C. Which of the following value of the feed location can be chosen? So generally feed point location, if you observe that the feed point location is very close to the value L1. Okay, so L1 is 6.5. Okay, so which value is closer to 6.5? It is 2.5. So answer is D. Okay, an application requires high gain broadband antenna. The antenna is to be mounted on the surface of a large object with maximum height limitation of 1 by 10 of the wavelength. Which of the following configuration satisfies this requirement? So generally 4 edge gap coupled RMSA provides these requirements. Okay, so answer is D. So that's all from my side. I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. I hope this video information may be beneficial to you for the all the session of the NPTEL of the same subject. And in next lecture we will discuss the assignment solution of week 7. Till then, be happy, be safe, be fearless, and keep faith in Almighty. Thank you very much.